Here's the delivery of our new shed from Spacemakers on Route 40. They really worked with us to make a custom-sized shed to get into our backyard because we have a difficult access. So that shed is 6 feet wide by 16 feet long. And what the delivery driver is using now is something called a mule. It's gonna forklift that whole shed up. The neighbor's driveway and wheel it into the backyard. Really amazing to me how one man can handle all of that. Notice how the rest of the truck bed is lifting up with someone else's shed prepared for the next delivery. There's a lot of skill here. And now the main truck bed's extended bed is starting to retract as the shed is lowered down and the mule is taking the full weight of it. Because our neighbor across the street, Rick, coming out to see what's going on. Really done this several times. He is really smooth. He knows exactly what needs to be done. And here we have some bicyclists coming by. We do live in a pretty neighborhood. Highly recommend Spacemakers if you are on the hunt for a new shed or storage building. They have been great to work with. I've heard nothing but good things about the quality. They're willing to customize to meet your specific needs. And we're looking forward to having this shed for a very, very long time. It is the middle of July, July 19th, and it is already about 85 degrees out here and terribly humid in Delaware. It's been extremely humid. So I am glad that our delivery driver is pacing himself, because just standing here doing this video, I'm working up a nice glistening perspiration. Really have to just take your time. Breeze out there this morning. When it's blowing, it makes it quite tropical feeling. Looks like he's securing the door so it doesn't come loose while he's moving it. Pretty serious piece of equipment. His car and their storage container this morning so that we could go up his driveway, because we have such tight access to our backyard. We removed one fence panel and we're going to get that in. Of course, the final destination is as far away from the fence panel as possible, still being in our yard. So the delivery man walked the path and he thinks we're going to be able to do this, so it's all good. And all of a sudden we have traffic. Okay, it looks like we're clear to go. Oh my goodness, look at how that glides. Like it's not hundreds or, I don't know, thousands of pounds. I don't know how much this shed weighs. I'll have to ask him. conditioning unit. I'll tell you, he is doing a wonderful job. Trim back that cherry bush. We probably could have trimmed it back a bit more. This is pretty amazing. He's got the fence cleared. It's all good from here. He's taking his time. Look at that, that is really tight. It's a 6-foot shed through. Wow, look at those tires. What an amazing driver he is. What an amazing driver. Can't thank him enough. Through where the old pool was. This is not smooth terrain back here. The tree down a few years ago and been trying to get the stump out. I'm still not quite sure how he's going to get it on that pad that's prepared there against the fence, but I will be really interested to see it happen. This fellow must have been awesome at geometry, because he really knows his angles. He is just dealing with that old tree stump like it's not even a problem. Just skimming right over it. Oops, sorry, got that out of frame. I'm just so in awe here at his ability. Out of the way. I'd like to get a better angle to see what he's doing, but I just don't want to get in this man's way. Okay. Looks like we'll be doing a little bit of repair work on the edging around the where the gravel is. That's not a big deal at all. Not a problem at all. He says flooded the gravel bed with sound, so that was fine. Taking the mule out from that direction. So it looks like instead of pulling, he's going to do some pushing from the back side. I'm going to just angle over here. Take out the pergola, or the grapevine. Everything is just terrific. Good thing I dug up our little fringe tree seedling, because it would have just been getting run over right now. We knew he was going to need some room. It can't just magically appear. We did discuss lifting it over the back fence because we are behind the shopping center, but those electrical wires just would not have allowed that to happen. They're just too low for clearance. And there she is. Look at that. Lifting it a little bit, probably to remove that pipe. That base was 2 tons of gravel under there. That's 4,000 pounds that my Jerry Bear moved from the driveway out front to the back here, one wheelbarrow full at a time. I helped with a few, but he definitely did the lion's share. But this is really exciting to finally get a shed and a handle on all of the yard clutter, potting clutter, good place to store the patio furniture over the winter. It's just going to be perfect. And again, that shed is 6 feet deep by 16 feet wide. underneath so still that this, we even discussed placement on the pad, if I wanted it completely in the center or off center. And we decided that with the slope of the roof, it's that lean-to type of roof, and the water will be draining off the front, that we wanted it to sit back farther so that all the water will end up in the gravel bed. Installation roller. It's amazing. It's an art how this was done. So glad I was here to film this. All in all, a difficult install from start to finish, 25 minutes. That was a very complex install. Looks like some leveling might be going on there.
Over there?
Absolutely.